a final thing relating to UVs that we'll attack here is the fact that we don't have specifically something like Gator that exists inside of Maya. Gator is pretty much a all-in-one, multiple different things you can do with one single tool. We have multiple tools that we'll use to deal with this, and one of these things, of course, is UVs. We want to transfer UVs from one object to another, regardless of its point count and information. If we had the same kind of point count, perhaps we could just go ahead and in Softimage, we just drag and drop the UV setup from one onto the other. But if we had different point counts, of course, we'd go to Gator. Well, we do have an option here. If we go ahead and select this guy, then select this one, so the one that we want the UVs from, the ones that we want to send it to, we'll go under Mesh here and we'll do a Transfer Attributes. I'm just going to open up its option box. You notice that UV sets, all the current UV sets, or just the currently active one, will be sent along. It's going to do it in world space, so these guys are sitting right over top of each other. Local space would mean that it would have the same relative center. And then of course we have a UV in component. Component means that it will send it in actual sort of UV space. I know that's a little bit confusing saying this says UV right here, but the component will basically assign whatever number is on these guys. So if this is vertex 1 and this is vertex 1 over here, they'll share that same spot in there without them using actual projections. So I'm just going to use world space, transfer it, and you can see that despite the fact they're not the same in terms of overall point counts, it's used this here. Now when you're done with this, of course, if the reason why I'm in wireframe here is partly because I can see in here, but also so that you can see this purple that appears on the wireframe. This indicates a live connection. It says basically that what I'm doing to this object will be affecting the other one. So this is projecting its UVs in real time. So if I were to go ahead and take this guy and move him around, I'm going to change my actual UVs on these objects. So you may want to remember to take these guys and delete by type history, in which case it stops being live. You can see that it's no longer purple. In fact, just as a visual to see what will happen to this, if I move that over there, you notice that it's messed with that. Or if I edit, delete by type history, and go ahead and move that guy, the UVs will remain where they are. Now there is one situation under which this becomes a bit of an issue. Let's create like a simple object. Just go ahead and throw a bunch of joints in there. Smooth point. Of course, what I want is to alter the UVs on my wonderful character here. I know it's awesome. So how then can I go ahead and transfer something that is live information onto this object? If I have something that's doing a live update, if I go ahead and delete history, well, if I delete history, it removes all the skinning information. And if I delete by type non-deformer history, well, it will delete things like modeling, like add edge loops or extrusions and stuff like that, and leave the skinning alone. But it won't remove anything like a live projection, like our attribute. So if I want this to work, I have to go about it in a slightly different way. So for the sake of all you guys that are going to suffer this particular fate, well, one point or another, where you didn't have the UVs, you didn't have this referenced or anything like that, you're going to need this. So I'm just going to go ahead and duplicate this surface so it has the exact same point count. I will right click and I will unlock this guy. And so what I have here, of course, is this one, and this is just a duplicate. It's not actually connected to it. So when I grab this guy, you see this one turns purple. This guy is just a duplicate. He's free of that. But he has the same point count and the same point order as the original, and that's very important to me for this. Now let's say what I have is an earlier version of the model that maybe has different points. I can do the transfer UVs or whatever I want with that, or I could do the UVs on this guy and then apply them over to this guy afterwards. But the point is that you can have a different UV set on this separate object and then transfer them to this one without worrying too much. So let's say I want to do something really funky. Let's go ahead and let's grab that right there. We're going to do that transfer mesh transfer attributes. I'll let it delete by type history. So it's got this funky UV set versus this UV set. This guy's no longer required, but this guy is. I'm going to grab both of them, and I have to keep track of what these guys are named here. So here we go. We'll go to Windows and go to the Node Editor. And when I look at this, what I'll have here is some different shape nodes here. So I've got my original. This is an important one. And another original here. So, type history, make sure it's history is fully gone. That's the original one. That's the one that I want to send to. This is the shape that I want. I wouldn't have two originals if not for the fact that I had actually done the skin bind to it to begin with. I'm going to take this guy and send him to this guy. So I'm going to grab these, open them up. And what I want to do is out mesh to in mesh. So mesh to in mesh, and what that does is it will provide the UVs with all the information that's here, and we can see that. And then on this guy, I want to go ahead and tell it that it's an intermediary object, basically that it's invisible, doesn't exist except as essentially history becomes history. So if we go into this guy here, we go to its channel box, you'll see that we've got just basic information inputs. Skin cluster is still there. We look at this, it still moves around, it still manipulates based on our weighting, all that stuff is there, but our UVs have shown up. And we notice that we can move this guy around without worrying about the UVs shifting around. Now, additionally, we can also do a delete to former history on this guy. I'm just going to leave this guy up so you can see what happens here. If I do an edit, delete by type, non-deformer history, that object now goes away. So the intermediary object is now gone. It's no longer sitting in the scene, yet the UVs remain. So that's how you can go ahead and deal with that situation if you've run into that problem. And hopefully that will work out for you.